Yang was the chairman of the session. And so the question was posed formally to the chairman. And Yang said, well, T.D. Lee and I have looked at that, but it doesn't lead anywhere. But we didn't find that it led anywhere. That was it. So Feynman didn't push this much further. Then in May, in Moscow, at that meeting that I described, I mentioned that there were various hypotheses about the tau and theta and parity. And so they scheduled a lecture on the subject. And the hall was completely full, standing room only, and there were people standing. And there were many people who couldn't get in. And I described this idea, ascribing it to Marty Block, and saying that Feynman had proposed it to the meeting, and that I had endorsed it, and that it was a possible idea that parity was simply not conserved in the weak interaction. Or there was the idea of parity doubling, which I had thought of but not published, and which Yang and Lee had published. And the third hypothesis, which I thought was very unlikely, was Marshak's very ugly hypothesis. Marshak was right there. I said, Marshak's very ugly hypothesis that it's a 2+ state. And that the tau spectrum is really not what it seems to be. And parity is conserved.
You wouldn't have a flat spectrum, of course.
No. So, the idea that parity was not conserved was very upsetting to some people. And they got up and said, but parity has to be conserved. Are you suggesting that Lorentz invariance is wrong too? What about rotational invariance? This is just a silly idea. And I said, well, look, I didn't propose this, but it is a perfectly possible hypothesis. Parity conservation does not come from reflection of coordinates. It comes from the transformation properties of the Hamiltonian of the interaction concern. In the case of the weak interaction, nobody has ever really tested whether parity is conserved. Well, actually, I didn't know it, but there had been an experiment in 1928 that tested it and found that it wasn't conserved. It's still not known whether that experiment was really correct or whether the result was an artifact, but I didn't know that it had been tested back in 1928. What I should have done, if I had been a really serious person, was to propose a test right there. I could have said, well, sigma dot p is a sure. pseudoscalar spin direction depends on the momentum direction, then yes, it would be violated. I didn't say that, unfortunately. Anyway, there was so much interest that I had to repeat the talk immediately afterwards for a whole other audience, which also had standing room only. But the reaction of the big shots was very hostile to the parity violation idea. The parity doubling idea intrigued them. But the parity violation idea, they didn't like at all. Well, the more they resisted it, the more I thought, well, maybe it's true. Well, when I got back, Yang and Lee had changed their opinion and put forward the idea that it was not conserved and had this very, very complicated test of it, which was being carried out at low temperatures by Mrs. Wu and Ambler. Instead of suggesting just that they look for longitudinal polarization of beta rays, which would have been much simpler. Well, then, of course, the result was announced, and parity was violated, and many people were very, very shocked. To me, it was a very important development, but it was certainly not shocking. And to Feynman, it wasn't shocking, and to some other people, like Fermi and Dirac, it wasn't. Shocking. I'm told that when they announced to Dirac that parity was violated in the weak interaction, he said, parity? Oh yes, parity conservation. Is that in my book? And of course it isn't. As a consequence of that, people began to think about possible theories. And Salam and Landau, who was finally converted, although he hadn't believed in the whole thing, and I think maybe one other person, suggested this 1+γ5 idea, which I had been thinking about for a brief period earlier. But it was actually 1 minus gamma 5 that they were talking about, because the data supposedly indicated scalar and tensor interactions. Right. And therefore, the parity, the sign of the parity violation was actually wrong. People thought the electrons were spinning in one direction when they were really spinning in the other.